I have an in the middle doorknob.
Lauren?
I'm sorry, Scott.
You should have listened to me, Mr. Shelby. I told you to drop the investigation.
Your son is a serial killer. How many people does he have to kill before you turn him in?
Gordy has his faults, but he's still my son. You have no children, Mr. Shelby. You can't possibly understand. You leave me no choice. Your investigation is over. For good.
Oh, shit.
Lauren! No! No! Shit!
Oh, fuck. I gotta get out! I gotta get out!
Lauren! Lauren, wake up!
Ugh. No time, I can't save her. I must save myself. Cut it! Sorry. Uh-oh. Oh shit. Of course not. With your feet, kick with all your might. Sorry, I'm a coward. He never did anything for me anyway, and he got me in that spot, so... I'm a heartless asshole.
Bastard. I'm gonna kill you.
And as we've seen from the convenience store, I'm not much of a, hero. We'll miss Lauren. And that is a freaky face. Oh, man. I'm all delirious. Oh, hang on to that now. No, I got hit. I'm not the invincible Scott Shelby. I never did like the quick time events with the trigger buttons. I always mess those up for some reason. And I hit that button. I didn't push it down far enough, I guess. kicking the door.
Stay back! Don't come near me, or I'll shoot!
Fucking asshole.
Please, don't hurt me.
Don't hurt me.
Bastard! Lauren is dead! You fucking killed
Stop.
Her!
Stop! I beg you!
Your idiot son killed all those kids, didn't he? He's the origami killer.
No! No! He's innocent! He's not a killer! Not a killer!
You're a fucking liar! Now tell me the truth!
No! No, please! Don't hurt me!
Last chance.
I don't know! I swear! I don't know anything!
It's an awful lot of trouble for not knowing anything that you just put me through.
Stop! Stop! I beg you. I'll tell you everything.
Gordy always wanted his fun, you know. He wanted to be like the origami killer. He kidnapped that kid and he held him under the water for a little too long. It was an accident. An unfortunate accident. He just wanted to play. He told me everything. He was crying. He was so sorry for what had happened. Whatever he did, Gordy is my son.
No one will miss him.
What?
That boy, Gordy killed. No one will miss him. Just street trash, like so many others. Oh.
You disgusting pile of shit. And what about John Shepherd? Why did you put flowers on his grave?
I own the construction site where he died. I never forgot. I've been putting flowers on his grave for 30 years.
What?
John had a twin brother. What happened to him?
I don't know. He was adopted, I think. His mother should know. Her name is Anne. Anne Shepherd. That girl, Lauren. She was just a whore. You'll forget her in no time. Come and work for me, Shelby. I'll pay you well. You'll be able to have all the girls you want.
Never say her name again. You hear me? Never.
Let's not forget about all the cronies you killed, guy.
My heart! My heart! Quickly! I need my pills. In that drawer, there.
He killed Lauren. He got what he deserved.
See you later.
Shelby! Come back! I fucking order you! Come back!
No, that guy's not getting any of our sympathy. Fuck that shit. Alright. Had quite an eventful last 15 minutes or so. We've got 2 casualties already. 3 if you count the guy from the beginning. 2 casualties in the last 15 minutes.
John Shepherd died 30 years ago. Hope his mother has all the answers to this puzzle.
Hello, I'm looking for Anne Shepherd's room. Please sign the visitor's book.
Use a fake name.
Are you a member of the family?
Yeah, you could say that.
Oh, she'll be pleased to have a visitor. No one ever comes to see her. With the Alzheimer's, she has trouble remembering things, but it'll still please her, you know. It's room 19 at the end of the corridor. Thank you.
All right, we're making some progress.
Room 19. Where is that?
Follow the signs on the wall. Room 19 at the end of the corridor. Uh-oh. Get out of my way, lady.
Only a few hours left before Sean Mars dies. Hope I'm not wasting my time.
Better not be.
Room 19. Where is that?
Right there. Come on in. Beep.
Hello, Mrs. Shepherd.
Is it time for my pills already?
No, Mrs. Shepherd, I...
They're never on time with my pills. I don't know what they do here. In the other hospital, they were always on time. But here...
Huh.
My name is Madison Page. I'm a journalist. I'd like to ask you some questions about your son.
I don't like this hospital. The food isn't very good, you know.
You may have to jog her memory.
Your other son, Mrs. Shepherd, John's twin brother. What was his name?
What other son? I have no other son. I never had any children.
Don't lie.
You had a son named John, and John had a twin brother.
Do you have my pills? It's time for my pills.
I'm not the staff, lady.
I know what happened at Carnaby Square. Do you remember?
Carnaby Square. I think I used to live there a long time ago. We didn't have much money at the time, you know. We had to make do with very little.
Mm-hmm.
Try to remember, Mrs. Shepherd. John's twin brother was placed with a foster family after the accident. What was the name of the foster family?
I asked them for a television, you know. They said I didn't have enough money. It's a pity. I'm fond of television.
There's one right there. It's right there.
I think your son is in trouble, Mrs. Shepherd. He's done some terrible things. I need to find him. Do you understand?
Terrible things you're telling me. He never came to see me, can you believe it? In 10 years, never. No one forgets their mother, do they?
I hope not.
Do you remember John?
My Johnny. He is a good little boy, you know.
Mrs. Shepherd, your son may be linked to a series of murders. Perhaps you have some information that could help the investigation.
Are you a new nurse? Where are my pills?
This is not helping. All right, well, we're gonna have to jog her memory somehow. I didn't come all the way down here for nothing. Or did I? I don't know.
All right, no point in wasting my time. I won't learn anything more by staying here.
Oh, hello.
Are these your children, Mrs. Shepherd? John and his brother? Is that them?
They're good little boys. Their father never looked after them. Always drinking. They didn't have an easy life, you know.
That sucks. Like, she just, like, goes rooting through all of her shit.
Mm-hmm.
The dog. Something about that shape makes me think I have to do it.
Oh, you know how to do these little dogs, too. My children loved origami. I taught them how to do it. John loved the little dogs. He always wanted to call them Max. Max, Max, Max. All dogs with the same name. I was wasting my time telling him they couldn't all have the same name. But he always wanted his paper dogs Max. It's funny, isn't it?
Max. What else is over here? What is this?
Did you make these origami figures?
My little paper animals. They played with them for hours. I showed my boys how to make them, you know.
Yes, your boys, Mrs. Shepherd. John and... what was your other son's name again?
My other son? I only had one son. My little Johnny.
This is just convenient. There was something else here. I thought. Sitting in a chair beneath the TV.
Her memory is coming back. Don't stop now. Just remember.
Remember. Maybe if I open the closet?
You don't seem to get many flowers, Mrs. Shepherd.
No, but I love them. My son knows that I love flowers. I know he'll bring me some.
We passed some flowers on the way in. Let's go pilfer some perennials, eh? Right. Just one flower. No one will notice one flower. Maybe several. I don't know. Wouldn't that be ironic if we came back and she'd like had a heart attack or something? Too much stimulation for one day.
What a lovely orchid. My sons loved orchids. We used to grow them in the back. When John died, I laid orchids on his grave. I cried when they told me. I'd already lost one of my children, and now they were taking away another one, you understand.
The foster family, Mrs. Shepherd. What was the name of the foster family that adopted John's brother?
They were really very nice people. I met them, you know. In the beginning, I used to go and see my little boy. And then I got sick and I couldn't go any longer. Perhaps he thought I'd forgotten him. He must have thought I didn't love him anymore.
His name, Mrs. Shepherd. What was his name?
But I loved him. If you only knew how much I missed him.
Please, Anne. His name. What was his name?
Come closer.
It's secret telling time. Oh, shit. Okay, now she knows who it is. Or so she thinks. It's Ethan's turn. Alright, I think this is a good time to stop. We've got a bit of a breaking point here in the plot. So when we come back, I'm not sure if we'll finish in the next set or not. There's not too much longer left, actually. So we'll get back to it. Thanks for watching. See you later.